When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street, USA.
I have so many things I want to do for you. I have so I have so many longings that belong to you. So love, don't turn away. I have so many songs I want to sing to you. I have so many smiles that I could cry. I have so many kisses I could bring to you. Love, don't pass me by. I can't offer you lots of fancy things to make you come and stay, but I could wash your socks and mend your coat and cook you lots of good things every day. So love, if you're looking for a happy place, I've a heart that is absolutely
Well, who could ever turn away from a voice so silky and so golden that emboldened the American musical theater for a very brief time in the 1960s? Hello, this is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on 88.3 FM Peconic Public Broadcasting, emanating out of the Holiday Hamlet of Southampton, New York. That was the voice of Inga Swenson. And if you're a musical theater fan of a certain generation, those two words together just implied and conveyed a golden evening in the theater with a stunningly beautiful, tremendously talented, classically trained lyric soprano who was just one of the brightest newcomers of the 1960s. She's still with us. You may know her from the television show Benson, where she played Krause, the housekeeper. But in the late 50s and early 60s, she was this sort of glorious comet that shot over the theater district. And today, we're going to look at some of her highlights. Now, this may be obscure for some of you, but just listening to her, you'll see why she just evoked such a deep sigh from all musical theater enthusiasts. I was never lucky enough to see her on stage, although I spoke to her on the phone. I'll talk a little bit about that later. Inga Swenson came from Omaha, Nebraska. She was born decades ago and trained at Northwestern University, their famous theater program, which brought people like Warren Beatty and George Firth and William Daniels and Jerry Orbach, who actually was voted boy least likely to succeed in his class at Northwestern. That was told to me by George Firth. And here is a song from Inga Swenson's musical New York debut, New Faces of 1956. There was Maggie Smith and Nancy Andrews and John Reardon. Excuse me, but she was one of the standouts. And speaking of boys least likely to succeed, here is one of her solos, Inga Swenson's Boy Most Likely to Succeed from New Faces of 56.
Washington, why we sing to you, long may your banners fly. Washington, why we
the class will give you the graduation speech.
As we stand on the threshold of life, we, the graduating class of Washington High of 1904, I have a glimpse of the future ahead of us.
Valedictorian of the class.
President of the student body.
He's certainly the smartest and the handsomest boy in the whole school.
But what's the use of wishing? He never even looks at us. Personally, I think he's a cold fish.
He's the boy most likely to succeed in love. As an A1 student, he will lead in love. He's a valedictorian with all straight A's. He's got this proper Victorian in a proper day. Indeed, in love with the boy most likely to succeed. In love, and though I'm no honor student like he, and I'll never get a PhD, the boy most likely to succeed is most likely to succeed because he's in love with
Washington.
Okay, not exactly a timeless classic, but it gives you an idea of Inga Swenson's range and how useful she was for the American musical theater stage in the 50s and 60s, because she looked like a million bucks, she could sing like a dream, and boy, could she act. As I said, she was classically trained, and it was actually many years before she sort of dug her heels in as a musical theater lead. She was a Shakespearean actress, and she would played Portia, and she played Juliet, and she played Ophelia opposite Fritz Weaver, another great American classical actor, and she was in Peer Gynt, a lot of Shakespeare. So it was no surprise in the early 60s when she narrated the text by Shakespeare of Mendelssohn's A Midsummer Night's Dream. So here is Inga Swenson displaying her classical chops with three separate monologues from A Midsummer Night's Dream, underscoring by that guy, Felix Mendelssohn.
Now the hungry lion roars, and the wolf behowls the moon, whilst the heavy ploughman snores, all with weary task foredone. Now the wasted brands do glow, whilst the screech owl, screeching loud, puts the wretch that lies in woe in remembrance of a shroud. Now it is the time of night that the graves, all gaping wide, every one lets forth his sprite in the churchway paths to glide. And we fairies that do run by the triple Hecate's team from the presence of the sun, following darkness like a dream, now our frolic. Not a mouse shall disturb this hallowed house. I am sent with broom before to sweep the dust behind the door. Through the house give glimmering light by the dead and drowsy fire. Every elf and fairy sprite hop as light as bird from briar. And this ditty after me sing and dance it trippingly. First rehearse your song by rote, to each word a warbling note. Hand in hand with fairy grace will we sing and bless this place.
Inga Swenson with the lyrics, as it were, by William Shakespeare. Great job. Well, one of the reasons I was inspired to devote a whole hour to Inga Swenson, well, actually two reasons. One is she's, I think, fantastic. As I said, I've never saw her on stage, but just listening to her makes you feel as if you were, you know, sitting in row E, 101 and 102. The other is I discovered an album out of the blue a couple of weeks ago called I'm Old Fashioned, and Inga Swenson went into the Liberty, or a very, you know, recondite album recording studio to make an album of 12 standards conducted and arranged by Peter Matz. Nobody greater than Peter Matz, in my opinion, in that regard. And I want to share some of those songs with you. I've never heard them before. Here is a great Rodgers and Hart song, one of my favorites, A Ship Without a Sail.
When love leaves you all alone, you're living in the past. Then you feel so small alone, and oh, the world seems vast. You tell your grief to no girls, you never make it known. Your smile is like a showgirl's, your laugh a hollow tone.
Could be better than Inga Swenson and Rodgers and Hart. Little apologies for the quality of that recording. It's taken from an LP, but I'm sure you'll all agree it was worth it. Well, Inga Swenson had made her name and made a name for herself as a classical actress in the early 60s. And then when Schmidt and Jones, fresh from their success in The Fantastics, went under contract with David Merrick to adapt N. Richard Nash's The Rainmaker into a musical, they picked Inga Swenson to play the lead, Lizzie Curry, in 110 in the Shade, a show which made her a star, even though she was second billed after Robert Horton, who was a TV star in it. And it's a story of a quote-unquote plain girl in Depression, Oklahoma, who is romantically awakened by a rainmaker who comes into town and threatens the sort of miracle that no one really believes is humanly possible. Anyway, a local reporter at the time said, the critics all knew she was a great classical actress, but when she opened her mouth and sang in this lyric soprano, everyone, quote, flipped their lids. And it is one of the great performances, certainly, of the 1960s, in my opinion. Here is Inga Swenson as Lizzie Curry, sort of having it out with Robert Horton, the putative rainmaker from 110 in the Shade.
Con man. Fake.
Lizzie, stop fiddling with your buttons. Fiddling with your buttons, Lizzie. Nice white dress, all buttoned up tight. Lizzie, stop fiddling with your buttons. Better check again for certain. Don't want to miss a button, Lizzie. What are you afraid of?
Leave me alone.
What are you afraid of?
Let go my arm.
You try to be so high and mighty. You act like you're cool as can be. You may fool your brothers and all of those others, but sister, you're not fooling me.
You ride in your bright painted wagon. You think that you're something to see. You're not fooling me.
Wait a minute. The minute I came here, you didn't like me. Why not?
Because you're a liar and a fake.
How do you know I'm a liar? How do you know I'm a fake? Maybe I can bring rain. Maybe that's my one and only blessing.
There's no such blessing in the world.
I've seen even better blessings, Lizzie girl. I got a brother who's a doctor. You don't have to tell him where you ache or where you pain. He just comes in and he lays his hand on your heart. And pretty soon you're breathing sweet again. And I got another brother who can sing, and when he's singing, the song is there, and it never leaves you. I used to think, why ain't I blessed like Fred or Arnie? Why am I just a nothing man with nothing special to my name? And then one summer comes the drought, and Fred can't heal it away, and Arnie can't sing it away. But me, I go down to the hollow, and I look up, and I say, rain, damn it, please, let the rain come. Let the rain come. Let the rain come. And the rain came. And I knew I was one of the family. That's a story. You don't have to believe it if you don't want to.
I don't believe it. You ride in your bright painted
you try
wagon.
To be so high
you
and mighty.
That you're something
you
to
act
see.
Like your class can
you may
be.
Fool the locals
you
with
may
such
fool your brothers
focus,
and
but,
all
mister,
of those
you're not
others,
fooling me. Not
me.
Not me.
Lizzie, I'm sad about you. You don't believe in anything, not even yourself. You don't even believe you're a woman. And if you don't, you're not.
It's not true. It's not true. It's not true. I'll buy myself a brand new dress that's cut way down to here.
Lizzie.
I'll buy some dime store diamonds and pierce them through my ear.
I'd like to see that.
I'll paint my mouth a rosy red. I'll pour peroxide on my head. I'll knock those poor old cowboys dead.
Elizabeth.
You don't believe me? Well, just watch. I'll be so raunchy, dancing in my pink and green sateen, feeling like a queen. Wearing Maybelline, I'll be so raunchy, gonna make them other gals turn green. Honky-tonkin' every night, I'm a raunchy kind of gal. I'll be so raunchy, sippin' Dr. Pepper mixed with booze, burning like
a fuse. Shaking my caboose, I'll be so raunchy. Stepping in my patent leather shoes. When the cowboys see me strut my stuff, gonna crawl right on their haunches, 'cause they just can't seem to get enough. I'm a raunchy kind of. Ha ha!
Inga Swenson showing the other side of her character as Lizzie Curry in 110 in the Shade. That was Will Geer singing with her as her father, H.C. Curry. Most people know Will Geer as Grandpa on The Waltons, but his career stretched all the way back to the Federal Theater Project in the 1930s. Well, 110 in the Shade occasionally gets revived. Audra McDonald played it about 10 years ago, but it is one of the great scores in the Rodgers and Hammerstein tradition, in my opinion. Here is a beautiful duet, which I'm shocked never got covered or never got further airplay, between Inga Swenson as Lizzie Curry and Sergeant File, the sort of decent guy who likes her and she can't quite admit that she's emotionally available for him, partly because he's also been divorced. So interesting idea, but a fantastic duet. A man and a woman from 110 in the Shade.
A man and a woman can be so close together that they almost become like one. They promise to love till life is done. A man and a woman can be part of each other, but somehow it is very strange. The things that you love the most can change. Hard times come, and when they do, you don't mean what you say. And once you have hurt each other, you start to drift away. Then the man and the woman who were so close together can be suddenly so alone, forgetting the lovely moments they've known. And the man and the woman must go back to just living all alone.
It doesn't have to be like that. It doesn't need to end that way. I know it's hard, and yet I feel that you can make it last forever. Can be so close together that they almost become like one. They promise to love till life is done. A man and a woman can be part of each other, and though troubles may come and go, the love that they have inside can grow. Come, but that's all right. You know that you'll pull through. As long as you have each other, there's nothing you can't do.
And the man and the woman who were so close to
together can be closer as time goes by. As long as they both are willing to try, then the man and the woman will grow closer until the day they die. It may be true, I just don't know.
I feel so sure it could be so.
A love can last until you die.
A great number from 110 in the Shade. This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on 88.3 FM, Peconic Public Broadcasting. And I just want to say, where else on the airwaves or the digital waves or whatever the heck they call that stuff, the streaming thing, are you going to get an hour devoted to a underappreciated genius like Inga Swenson, the great romantic heroine of the middle 1960s in the American musical? So I would encourage you at this time of year to think about donating to WPPB. You can go online to peconicpublicbroadcasting.com and give a donation. We really need the bucks, folks, and boy, is our programming worth it. Well, I'm going to return now to the world of Inga Swenson and this album she made in 1964. Again, like Julie Andrews or a number of other people, she did cut these albums of standards, which were pretty impressive. And here are two It Never songs, It Never Was You from Knickerbocker Holiday and It Never Entered My Mind by Rodgers and Hart, both sung by the incomparable Inga Swenson.
Thank you. I've lost the very meaning of repose. I never put a mud pack on my face. Oh, who'd have thought that I'd walk in a daze? No, I never go to shows at night, but just to matinees. Now I see the show. Go, once I laughed when I heard you say that I'd be playing solitaire, uneasy in my easy chair. It never entered my mind. Once you told me I was mistaken, that I'd awaken with the sun and ardor orange juice for one. Scratch my back myself. Once you warned me that if you scorned me, I'd sing the maiden's prayer again and wish that you.
Inga Swenson and the incomparable Peter Matz at the keyboard. Two classics. I think that Inga Swenson became with the next show, I would say, what, the American Julie Andrews for a brief shining moment. This was a musical version of the Sherlock Holmes stories called Baker Street. And they were looking for someone, the producer Alexander Cohen said, who had a kind of Kay Kendall, British devil-may-care quality. And as Inga Swenson herself told me, they found her in a tour in the national tour of 110 in the Shade. And she said, I was so thrilled to get rid of my Depression-era smocks and put on some gorgeous Victorian frocks. And she played Irene Adler, the kind of nominal girlfriend of Sherlock Holmes, who can't really have a girlfriend and still be Sherlock Holmes. And as in the original story, she was an American actress who came to London and gets involved with a blackmailing scandal and finds herself in the Sherlock Holmes circle. Anyway, here's a number, her opening number in Baker Street, and it was written on the road by Bach and Harnick, and it was ultimately thrown out, and another number was put, one of these crazy, wacky things. Anyway, the wonderful Inga Swenson singing I'm in London Again from Baker Street.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You've been a wonderful audience. I'm in London again. Your warm reception has quite taken my breath away. I shall never forget this debt of gratitude, impossible to repay. I've discovered again your reputation for reserve is profoundly untrue. I'm so proud to be here in this jubilee, here in London again with you. I'm in London again, and that's the only thing that matters to me tonight. I'm in London again, so I'll enjoy myself whatever the critics write. I would love to remain, but who's to say if we're to run for a year or a day? But a day or a year, it's so good to be here in London again with you.
She's in London again. The fog receded when the curtain began to rise.
She's in London again. I see her scintillate and something within me dies.
We must live in suspense till she's decided who her new cavalier is to be.
It's so perfectly dear having all of you here. London again. I know your critics, and already I feel a chill. Every word that they write is retribution for the Battle of Bunker Hill. Let them say what they will, I know my spirits will remain irrepressibly high. I'm invincible here. I'm in London again.
And resplendent.
And in London.
She may well overwhelm every girl on the realm. Our American guest,
Emma.
She's in London.
A delicate subject on which I have little to say, and yet there are difficult subjects I'd gladly debate half the day. Finding words for spring is no easy thing. Still, I'm sure I'd find a few. What words could be right to describe the night? Somehow I would find them too. How can one explain love's sweet splendor? The most tender words won't do. You must fall in love, then you'll find that love will explain itself to thank you.
should you want to praise lazy summer days, I could find a phrase or two. As for love, mere words, though they're clever, they'll just never do. You must fall in love, then you'll find that love will explain itself.
Inga Swenson in her Tony-nominated performance from Baker Street. She was nominated for that and 110 in the Shade. She had the bad luck to run up against some major stars both those years, so she never won a Tony, but she certainly did in my heart. I remember when I was in ninth grade, I had a copy of The Memoirs of Sherlock Holmes, and someone actually put her picture on the cover. How interesting is that? Anyway, here's the Act One finale of Baker Street with Fritz Weaver and Virginia Vestoff and Peter Salas, one of those rousing Act One closers, but you can see how much fun she had doing it from Baker Street.
After your show tonight, Miss Adler, I shall ask you to play an extra performance with me. We shall appear as members of the lower class and journey through the underworld of London.
Daisy!
Yes, Mum?
What shall I wear?
The red, Mum?
No.
The blue?
No, that's hopeless.
What about the mauve, Mum?
What?
The mauve with the bustle.
Gorgeous. On you.
What? With my derriere?
I've simply got nothing to wear. I was mad to say yes, but I'm glad nonetheless. What a night this is going to be. There's the scent, there's the hum of adventure to come. What a night this is going to be. Tonight's a night that's fraught with excitement. Tonight is a night meant for me. For tonight I'm with him. Win or lose, sink or swim. In or out, wrong or right, what a night this is going to be.
Watson.
Yes?
How do I look?
Dreadful.
Good. Eyebrows?
Eyebrows?
Yes or no?
Well, I wouldn't.
Then I should. So it's off to the hunt in a few minutes' time. What a night this is going to be. Now at last I confront that Napoleon of crime. What a night this is going to be. Tonight there'll be an intimate party for just Moriarty and me. And Miss Adler, of course. Perhaps I should feel remorse, for she can't know just quite what a night this is going to be.
Somehow it is strange I'm not afraid of all the dangers of tonight.
Oh, ma'am, I know you wait. But as for me, I feel I'm going
compared
to faint.
Compared to what's in store now, all the rules I played before now seem so
trite. It's just about complete.
By Jove, you look a treat.
Just to think that she puts her trust in me. Who can know how it may go? Together we shall see.
What a night this is going to be. I've never had such fun. There's never been skullduggery before the night is done.
There's a dash, there's a dash in the air everywhere. What a night this is going to be. Just look into your mind. Miss Adler, I swear I'm so beside myself, I think I'm going to cry.
Tonight's a night that's fraught with excitement. Tonight is a night meant for me.
So it's on with the case.
And there's no time to spare.
So it's off to the chase.
Oh, Miss Evan, take care.
Come on, babe, come on, fight. What a night it is going to be.
From this time forth, you are Mrs. Brasser Bates of Bethnal Green. Is that perfectly clear?
As clear as a pineless window, love. And speaking of drafts, I feel a bit of a chill in the air. So if I holds on like a sailor's girl, it's warmth, not intimacy, I'm seeking, mind, love.
Your A's are a trifle flat.
Hello, ducks.
Hello, sweet. My, you do look at sweet.
What a night this is going to be.
Come on, give us a kiss.
What, in public like this?
What a night this is going to be. Tonight's a night just right for a blowout. Tonight is just my cup of tea.
What a lark.
What a laugh.
What a caper.
Not half. What a spree.
What a splash.
What a binge.
What a bash.
You're a bit of all right.
Mr. Fight, you're a sight.
What a night. This is going to be.
And the curtain comes down on a musical adventure of Sherlock Holmes, Baker Street. Well, one of the interesting things is that Fritz Weaver, who played Sherlock Holmes in that, had played Hamlet to Swenson's Ophelia, Peer Gynt to her Solveig, and in 67 would play Henry Higgins to her Eliza at City Center. My Fair Lady, of course, unfortunately never recorded. Well, that same year in 67, she did an original Richard Rodgers musical for television based on Androcles and the Lion by Shaw, another Shavian musical adaptation. And here her paramour was a Roman soldier played by John Colum. And I can't imagine two more wonderful people. And it's a lovely song, Strangers, from Androcles and the Lion.
Lavinia, do Christians know how to love?
It's what they do best, Captain. They even love their enemies.
Is that easy?
Very easy, Captain, when they're as handsome as you.
You're laughing at me again, Lavinia.
At you, Captain. Impossible.
Then you're flirting with me, which is even worse.
Oh, no, Captain. I never flirt with strangers.
We're not exactly strangers, Lavinia. We've been traveling together on this road for 3 days and nights.
Nevertheless, if strangers are persons who know nothing of one another, then don't you agree that you and I are more surely strangers now than when we met?
I'm a stranger to you, I know. You're a stranger to me. And so if there's something better than being strangers, that's the way to go. As a start, we could really try to look out with a kindly eye and regard each other with friendly glances and a friendly sigh. When you're standing here with your face so near, I can see you clearly growing dearer, dear. If you stumble, I'll break the fall. If you run to me when I call, then we'll find we never were really strangers after all.
Lavinia, listen to me. The men in that audience tomorrow will come to the Colosseum to satisfy one vile and horrible passion. the lust and excitement of seeing a beautiful woman torn, shrieking, limb from limb.
They cannot violate my soul, Captain. Only I can do that by sacrificing to false gods.
And so you would die.
Don't think that will be easy. Our faith makes life far stronger and more wonderful than when we walked in darkness. A martyr's agony is as bitter as his triumph is glorious.
A martyr's a fool, Lavinia. Your death will prove nothing at all.
Then why kill me?
Christian prisoners are not allowed to draw the Emperor's officers into argument and ask questions for which military regulations provide no answer.
Oh, shame on you, Captain.
A little incense on Diana's altar, Lavinia, that's all. If you can't do it out of conviction, at least do so as a matter of good taste, to avoid shocking the sensitivities of your fellow citizens.
Oh, you said they were looking forward to it.
Not all of them, Lavinia. Not all.
Why, Captain?
I'm a stranger to you, I know.
You're a stranger to me, and so if there's something better than being strangers,
that's the way to go.
You could say, if you really try, all the things that your looks imply. Is it more than merely some hopeful glances and a hopeful song?
When you're standing here with your face so near,
I can see you clearly growing dearer.
Dear, if you stumble, I'll break the fall.
If I run to you when you call,
then we'll find we never were really strangers
that I had never met you.
But if when you hear my love call ringing clear,
and I hear your answering echo so
was Inga Swenson at the 1982 Tony Awards with, of all people, Robert Goulet singing from Rosemary. That is the last time we've seen her on stage in New York. She had a great career on television, on Benson and on soap, and we love her dearly. She's still with us on the West Coast. Inga Swenson, one of my favorites ever. Here she is delivering the Act One closer to 110 in the Shade. And if there's ever been a more bravura curtain closer, I don't know what it is. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you enjoyed an hour with Inga Swenson.
Lizzie! Lizzie!
Time all gone to. This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing.